Okay, so our next speaker is Manolis Sourligas, and Manthos,
Manthos
knows him very well, is going to present him, so we can swap the roles for a second if you prefer.
It's the presentation, yes?
SDR makers.
Yeah. Okay, so to present Manolis, come on, Manolis didn't send anything about his CV, and he said that I know everything. So he is colleague and friend in LibreSpace Foundation, and he's main job is to sailing the seas with his sailboat, and his hobby is to do stuff with SDRs and also a PhD on computer science and SDRs.
Welcome.
Hello, everyone. As Mathon said, I'm Manolis. Nice to see you all here, and many familiar faces from last OSCW. Today I will present you our work in LibreSpace and our main project that runs currently, the SDR Makerspace. Just to start with, who doesn't know LibreSpace Foundation? Wow, this is very... One, okay, two. So just an initial... LibreSpace Foundation is a non-profit organization located here in Athens. Our main focus is in space applications, and we have a strong commitment on open source technologies. Everything that we do is open hardware and open software, and it is available on our GitLab repositories. Also, we have some kind of educational activities. We try to help schools with their projects like the CANSAT or stuff like that. LibreSpace Foundation was established in 2014 after winning the Hacker Day Prize, and the winning project was back then was the SAPNOX, which is our main project. It has grown a lot from back then, and at around 2018. A call came from ESA came out about doing SDR research on a more hacky happy way, and it was called the SDR Makerspace. Of course, when we saw this call, we were fully committed to write the proposal, write it the proper way. So, a great team of engineers and managers and stuff like that gathered around, and for 1.5 months, if I recall well, we prepared the proposal. And after three months, a very good answer came from ESA that we won the SDR Makerspace program. So what about this project? It's an ESA and LSF collaboration. It has a budget of around €500,000 euros, and its main goal is to investigate the use of SDR technology in space. It is an umbrella of around 15 smaller sub-activities. Many of them include GNU Radio contributions to GNU Radio. And of course, as I said, we are fully committed to open source hardware and software. So all of our results of during these projects are available on our GitLab repo. So today I will describe some of the most important projects that I have already completed. And the first one is GRSOP. So how many of you have used the GR Osmocom? Okay, and what did you hate about this module? Come on, don't be shy.
Packaging.
Sorry?
Packaging,
okay. Other one? Personally, I hate the settings because it has some default settings about gains or parameters that I don't know exactly how they are applied to the SDR hardware. Okay, and the second one was the lack of documentation. So another project came up called SOPI, which is an API that tries to provide a unified way for communicating and with the SDR hardware and also doing the configuration. So during this project, the GR SOPI, we developed a GNU Radio out of three module that tries to provide a unified way to use different SDR devices with a single block. So, for example, here you can see a source block. Source block in GNU Radio is, it means that you read from the device, so actually you're doing reception. Does not appear very well. So you can specify which SDR device you use, and GR SOPI automatically expands the proper parameterization. So, for example, here for the AirSpy, I have the exact gain parameters that AirSpy supports. If, for example, I switch from SOPI to Lime for the Lime SDR, automatically the parameters change, and then the user knows exactly what gain values applies to what gain stages of the SDR device. Okay, so with this way, we try to provide a unified and easy way to use your SDR device. We also support most of the SDR devices out there. And lately we have managed to also integrate the support for SDR Play, which is not mentioned in this table. George behind there is a main contributor of GR SOPI, and we managed lately to port it on GNU Radio 3.8. And there is some discussions to integrate mainline on the GNU Radio core. Our next big activity was the GR Leo. It's a simulation tool of the Leo channel. It tries to calculate dynamically the path loss from the satellite ground station and apply atmospheric rain or other attenuation models on the path of the satellite and the ground station. It also, of course, injects the proper Doppler shift. And as we discussed previously with the other activity that do something similar, it's a great tool for experimenting, prototyping or testing the capabilities of both the ground station and the satellite. So GR Leo uses several entities that define these the path loss between the satellite and the ground station. Of course, the one entity is the satellite. So in GR Leo, we have a convenient way to define your satellite. Just pass a valid TLE, and the frequency of the satellite, and also we define the ground station, which is located in a specific place on Earth, and of course we need also a time window that you want your simulation to run. So currently we have no limit on the time window. The simulation will run until it reaches the target end date. So if you want to do mission planning and see the coverage of your ground station depending on your satellite, you can run it, for example, a year and see how many passes you will have on your ground station. So, as I said before, you can also use different standards for calculating the path loss. You can only use free space path loss, or introducing several other more sophisticated ones, like the ITU recommends. We have three different ITU recommendation attenuation models for rainfall, snowfall and just atmospheric one. And also we support parameterization on the antennas that you use. So the user can define which antenna has the ground station and the spacecraft. GR LEO takes into consideration the gains and the beam widths. And if you also specify a pointing error, GR LEO will handle that and take into consideration all of them. So this is an example of simulation of GR LEO. And we have tested the capabilities of the transceiver of our previous mission, the APSAT. Actually, it was 3 years before, but we didn't have this tool back then, but now we have it. And right now, we use it to do the mission planning for our two next satellites, Cubic 1 and Cubic 2, which will be Pocket Cube. And depending on the path loss performance that tool provide us, we do some kind of engineering decisions, like which modulation we're gonna use, or which channel bandwidth, or and stuff like that. So a great tool, and happy to see also the main developer Costis back then, back there. So yeah, this is a live view of a pass, and you can see the Doppler shift and how the signal attenuates it in the end of the pass, where the elevation is very low, and is the strongest one when the elevation is at 0 degrees angle. Sorry, 90. Another project is also the IQ Zip, which is a compression mechanism for compressing data from IQ data from SDR devices. So we have done some research about which algorithms we should use. I forgot to mention that all these algorithms are lossless, so no loss of information. As you can see, we had great success with LZMA algorithms and the CCSDS that managed to provide the compression ratios higher than 0.5 of the initial file size. And for mostly standardization reasons, we chose the CCSDS implementation. So we expect this the results of this subactivity to be integrated in the SatNOX network in the near future, because our plan is to provide a library with IQ data so everyone can download them and do research on them. So stuff like the guys from Orikit doing it would be very much more easier for them to do. Also, another activity that almost finished is GRCCSDS, which handles mostly the physical layer of the CCSDS standards, and we have managed to almost support all of the coding schemes that CCSDS dictates. And we are in the process of validating these results with a modem that ESA will provide us in a few weeks, in order to be 100% that we have implemented properly the standard and we are compliant with other modems or satellites too. Just to finish up with the last activity that is undergoing from Alex and Sila, it's the SDR hardware evaluation that tries to test everything, almost every device that currently exists out there. in terms of the noise floor, the receiver dynamic range, the TX and RX spectral purity, and also if they can transmit at the advertised power that they claim. So the results are, and all the research are on the on their wiki page. So I don't know if I have some. Okay, yeah. So all this from the SDR Makerspace program. If you have any questions, I will be glad to answer them.